Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing this eye look. It's in inspiration of this guy right here. I put the picture here. It's on Instagram. It's really good and I was in love. My friend actually sent me this eye look, so I decided to recreate it and I hope you guys like it. And if you would like to know and see how I recreate this look, please keep on watching. Okay, so today we're gonna be recreating, I'm gonna put a picture here of the look I'm gonna be recreating, and I have one eye done off camera because I was first trying to make it to see how it looks, and it's kind of difficult, I gotta say, but it's really fun. So we're gonna start with this Laura Mercier. This is a purple liner and it's really hard to work with, so you gotta be patient and you gotta be careful because it's so hard to work with that I have to pull my eye, but you have to be careful because don't pull too much your eye because it's gonna give you wrinkles. So what I'm gonna do is like trace my crease, and usually my crease like is really visible. You can see it where it's at, but I always go a little bit higher than what it is because I want you to see like my crease. If I do it too low, then it's not gonna look like this, if it makes sense. So I'm just gonna hold my finger like this and go higher than my crease, and then I'm gonna be closing and open my eyes so I can clearly cut my crease where I want. So I'm just gonna pull, and this pencil is really hard to work with. I don't know, it's because I had it for too long, but still like it's really hard to work with. So you're gonna be this is literally the second piece that it breaks. Let's go back again with a little piece now. Okay, so just relax your eye and pull it. Oh, it's working better. It's making me look bad. It's too short. That's why you gotta pull it when it's hard to mark your crease. And I'm gonna bring it all the way to my inner corner. And a way with cut crease, you kinda can be messy because you're gonna be cleaning it. But don't go too messy. This part because it's really hard. I have problems too, so just be patient and just try not to look directly to your mirror. And once you have this, kind of go by this eye. So that's what I'm doing. I'm just looking straight to my mirror, and then I'm just pulling my eye and looking back and forth to my both eyes so I can try to make it as close as they can. And remember, you can be messy because you're gonna be cleaning it with a concealer afterwards. I think the hardest thing is the curve. Like, it's hard. Like, it's, I don't know. If I don't pull my eye, this liner doesn't wanna trace. Okay, so I'm gonna leave it like this. I know it looks kind of straight and crazy, but I'm gonna try to fix it once I clean my crease. So I'm gonna be taking, for these purple colors, the Matrix and MAC collaboration, and I'm gonna be taking this brush from Real Technique, and this is the detailer brush. This is how it looks. And I'm gonna be taking this dark purple right here, because if you saw in the picture, it kind of shows how to recreate the look, and the purple is really dark. I'm just gonna be placing and packing all right here. So once I have this colorful pack, I'm gonna go with this brush from Sigma, it's the E25. And I'm gonna be taking this color right here. And now I'm gonna blend this color right here. And just literally going on top so I can blend a little bit off the purple color. And you gotta be patient because you gotta back and forth, blend until you get your desired color. Like this wasn't easy, it took me like a good half hour or so just on this eye. But you just gotta keep blending, and if you gotta go back and forth with your purple color so these two can blend, because the pencil is really hard to blend the eyeliner. So what I did is just going back and forth and kind of go a little bit higher with the purple so it can blend with the pinkish color. But not too high, because you don't want this purple to go really high, because then it's gonna be a black eye. So you're just gonna go back and forth. Okay, so once you got like this and you're happy when you're blending, you're gonna take a little bit of the pink, just one tap, so we can give it that little pinkyish color so it's not that mauvey. So only one tap, don't tap the excess, and lightly go over everything. And as you can see now, it looks more pinkyish and not so like mauvey pink. I think this pink kind of brings everything together. And then for our brown bowl color, I'm gonna be taking the Jaclyn Hill palette, and I'm just gonna be using this color right here. It's called Inlight. And I'm gonna take Elf C brush. And I'm gonna tap the exit. I'm just gonna put a little bit right here. And then I'm gonna go back with my blending brush and blend these two colors together, all these colors together. So once you're happy with the color, you're gonna take your, what did I use? Oh, I used my Naked Skin from Urban Decay Concealer, and this brush from Sigma is the F70. And I'm just gonna put a little bit of concealer on the back of my hand. I just feel this is really creamy and easy to blend, so that's why I grabbed this concealer, but you can grab anything that you had at home. And I'm just gonna pat just a little bit, because you don't wanna put too much, and we're gonna clean this crease. And now you see how it looks more clean and more kind of put together. So that's what we wanted. And he's using like a just bone color, but I picked the same eyeshadow from the Jaclyn Hill palette. But I'm just gonna set that before I place that eyeshadow. and I'm setting with Fenty Beauty. This is the Universal Powder. So now I'm gonna take In Light and I'm gonna place it all over my lip. Okay, so when you set your eyelid, this part was kind of difficult too, I'm not gonna lie. So because I don't have the glitter that he has, because it's kind of more bigger, I just took my Stila, how's it called, glitter and glow, metal, whatever, magnificent, and I'm just using Sea Siren and Diamond Dust. I'm just gonna put a little on the back of my hand and I'm gonna kind of mix them. And I also gonna add this Lime Crime eyeshadow glitter, and this is the shape, I mean the name, kind of the same. And I say it's kind of difficult because you gotta work really fast with these metal glows because they dry, and once they dry, it's not, you don't find anyone who can blend. And I'm gonna use the Sigma EO5, this is the eyeliner brush. So I'm gonna grab both. Once you have that, he left it like that, but because I'm gonna put lashes, I kind of wanted to do just a tiny little liner, tie line in my eyes, so everything can look well together. I'm just gonna go close to my lash line because I want my lashes to blend with my lid. The liner I used from Stila, and this is the Stay All Day Waterproof Liquid Liner. It's really good because it's going to be tiny. Now I'm going to apply lashes. These are from Huda Beauty and Samantha. And I'll put the picture. If not, they will be, I will put the name in the description box. Okay, so this is how my eye looks. I'm just gonna finish my face and I'll be back to put the blush, the highlight, and the lower lash line. Okay, now for my lower lash line, I'm gonna use the same dark purple color from the palette You Can Stay With Me. And I'm gonna use Sigma E20, which is a short shaded brush. And tap the excess because we have our foundation and we don't want to make our other eyes. The same thing my E25, and we're gonna do the same thing with it under the topper. Then we're just gonna grab this color from the other palette and then one tap of this hot pink and tap the eyeshadow, and we're gonna blend this. Now for waterline, I'm gonna be using a black color, and this is from Marc Jacobs. Can you see? I don't think it's doing anything. So I'm gonna put this down and I'm gonna grab from Rimmel London, and this is 001 black. So now we're gonna put some mascara on our lashes. I'm using Benefit the Rolling Lash Mascara, and I'm gonna put on my top and bottom. Now for blush, I'm gonna be taking also from MAC and Patrick Star. This is Take Me Home. I just in love with these blushes. And this is the mauve kind of pinkish color. What I do is I just tap once here, tap the excess because they're really pigmented, and just blend it in. And if you put too much, like I always do, I just take my powder brush and kind of blend everything together. And then for highlight, I'm gonna be taking out my Moonchild and Anastasia Beverly Hills, because with this purplish, I kind of want purple. So I'm gonna be taking Purple Horseshoes, and I'm gonna also take from her line too, the highlight brush. This is the 823. And I'm also gonna take from Anastasia and Amarese highlight. I just think it needs a little bit of goldish, beige, something. So I'm gonna take the same brush and I'm gonna mix these two together. Now for lipstick, because we have a really dramatic eye, I'm gonna take this pencil from Abel, and I'm gonna line my lips. I'm gonna take for the chapstick so it can be pigmented. And because we're using mostly MAC and Patrick Star collection, I'm gonna take Sweet Mama Star. And this is just a nude color. I'm gonna top it off with MAC lip gloss, and this is on Viva Glam Ariana Grande number 2. I just think kind of needs gloss. So this is the final look. It was kind of easy, I'm not gonna lie. I mean hard, but I mean easy. But yeah, if you like it, please give me thumbs up, subscribe for more, and I see you in my next one. Bye.